The Wally Show podcast is our daily radio show heard live through the WayFM app each morning and hosted by Wally, Gavin, and me, Betty Rock. For more fun, be sure to connect with us at wayfm.com/Wally.
The Wally Show podcast is brought to you by Colorado Christian University Online, where you can earn a degree online just like Betty Rock. You can learn more at ccu.edu/Wally. Things you didn't know you needed to know today. It's News-ish with Betty.
With the introduction to the smartphone, group texting conversations have become a thing. Why do you say it like that?
I'm not a big fan of group text.
I know a lot of men that aren't, you know, a fan of group texting. I even have a friend of mine. He might be a little bit older than you, but him and his wife, we always have in our group text. And he's like, leave me out of it. Just tell her and she'll tell me.
He doesn't
want to be a part of
that's it. How I operate. We have a small group text and I've kind of taken myself out. Because I know my wife will manage that and then she will tell me what I need to know.
Right.
I don't need... like things like that. So.
Well, because of group texting is a thing, that means we need to establish some basic rules for this whole situation. And here are some of the few that most would agree we should follow. First of all, if you would like to add someone into the group conversation after it's already been established, you should ask before throwing them in.
Yes, because... you don't look at everyone that's in the group text. You don't always know how many people are in there. And if they add somebody in there and, like, say you're not a fan or say you have an issue, it would be very nice to know that. Because I have responded to certain work texts that I did not know everyone was in on.
Well, and if in case you're wondering, the ideal amount of people in a group chat are 6 people. But it should never be more than 12.
That's
just
so many.
Too many. Yeah.
Yeah. If you have a family group text and you have more than 12, break it off or get another family.
I'm in a group text with 3 other people, and that's enough in itself.
Oh,
so that's 4 of us.
Well, especially because your friends are drama.
I love it. Second rule, no one should feel pressure to respond quickly in a group chat. So don't feel like, I mean, if your phone is constantly going off or whatever, don't feel like pressure to respond. Respond when you want, but if it's been over 48 hours, move on. Because that joke that was said 48 hours ago, don't respond to it. Nobody cares.
That kills me, because like I always... If I'm going to make a joke in one, like I do it right in that moment.
Yeah.
But like 3 hours later, someone is referencing something that the conversation's even moved beyond that.
Yeah.
And then they're making a joke from there, and you're like, really, Rick? Like, you're killing me.
And finally, I think this is one that me and Gavin would agree on. Wally, not so much. But if it's a work-related group chat, never text over the weekend. This is a work-life balance situation. And if you want to start that conversation, that should be more of an email situation instead of texting. Don't you think, Gavin?
I agree. I don't necessarily think of texting and work in the same breath over the weekend.
I agree with you, unless it's important.
Yeah, but to you, everything is
right.
Yeah.
Right. But we've sent TikTok videos back and forth
on
the weekends.
That's fine. That's fun. That's
it's
not
fun.
Work.
Right, exactly.
But if you're like, hey, so-and-so's coming in, I need so-and-so. Hey, have you heard blah, 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 blah. No.
We'll put a pin on it.
And we're not putting a pin.
You know what? Let's set up that group chat and we'll discuss it like that, okay?
Over the weekend.
Over the weekend. Uplifting WayFM, this is The Wally Show, and this is that time of year where there's, again, pumpkin spice everything. It usually starts with coffee, and then a candle or two, and then you start looking out, and it starts getting a little silly at points.
Yeah, like, don't they make, like, pumpkin spice goldfish or chips or they make bagels and Wally is all in on that.
Those I do like, honestly. That doesn't seem like crazy out of bounds, but I have found some things and I've made up some things, and your job is going to be to tell us which are real pumpkin spice products and which are the fake ones. So it seems pretty simple. Ugh. But it's harder than it seems, honestly. because people will try to make a buck off of anything and they can just take something and slap pumpkin spice on it.
And Wally and Gavin are there.
Yeah, pumpkin spice bail bonds. You know, we'll get you out and make you smell good. You know, it's a ridiculous time of year, but it is wonderful. So, if you want to play, you got a chance to win a prize right now. 855-33-WAY-FM. If you are a pumpkin spice aficionado and you live for this stuff, then you should have a pretty good handle on what is and what is not. pumpkin spice related. So if you want to play, 855-33-WAY-FM. Uplifting Way FM, this is The Wally Show. Jessica, are you ready to play our pumpkin spice game?
Yeah.
Now, are you a pumpkin spice aficionado? Have you had a pumpkin spice latte already this season?
Oh, I've had pumpkin spice everything.
Okay, good. Well, we're going to see how much you know about are these real or fake pumpkin spice items, okay? So here we go. Number one, pumpkin spice toothpaste. What do you think? Is that real or is that a made-up item?
That's probably real.
Okay, Betty Rock, what do you think? Pumpkin spice Crest toothpaste, made up or real?
Ugh, that has to be made up, or I hope it's made up.
Jessica said it is real, and fortunately for all of us, it is fake.
Oh, thank goodness.
There is not pumpkin spice toothpaste. So you did not get that one right, but that's okay. Number two, pumpkin spice Pringles. What do you think? Pumpkin spice Pringles, are those real or made up?
Maybe false.
I feel like I've seen these around.
Really?
Like I've seen them in the grocery stores. Spice. Jessica, would you buy them if they are real?
Yeah, I probably would. I'm not
going to
lie.
Okay. Yeah, well, see, there you go. Okay, well, you can stay with your answer, or if Betty Rock has influenced you, you can switch it.
I would say they're probably real. Okay. Pringles does make a bunch of weird flavors.
Yeah, they do. And every year they've got to stand out somehow in the potato chip game. So, yes, they are real, actually.
Hey!
You made a good choice to switch there. Pumpkin spice flavored dental dog treats. What do you think? Pumpkin spice flavored dental dog treats. So you want your dog's breath to smell like yours after going to Starbucks?
False. I don't think that they're real.
Ooh, I think they are. Just because, like, I know that some dog owners give their dogs pumpkin to help with other scenarios.
Oh, really? I didn't know
that. So why not make pumpkin spice dog treats? That just seems like something that
would happen. Why let the dogs miss out on all the fun, too?
Right.
You know?
Yeah.
Like, come on, man. Unfortunately, Betty Rock is really good at this game.
Oh.
You are right, Rock. They are real.
Woo!
Ugh.
Well, Jessica, I'm sorry that didn't work out for you today. But, you know, the good news is we have a lovely parting gift because you're such a delight. And we appreciate you being on the show with us. Uplifting Way FM, this is The Wally Show. And one of Betty's favorite things online is memes, you know.
Yes, they're just hilarious. And what's so funny, too, is I'll see a funny meme. I'll try and I'll show it to my mom or my dad, and I'll try and explain it. And it's like,
yeah, they don't get it.
Yeah, it just blows over their head.
And it's really hard to do memes on the radio show.
Yeah,
you know?
But that's where Audible Meme
love this
comes in handy. So what I like to do is I like to take a piece of a song that we have been playing for this one. We're going to use for King Country's "What Are We Waiting For." What are we
waiting for? Okay.
So I'm going to give you scenarios.
Okay.
And then you're going to play
the "What Are We Waiting For?"
Uh-huh.
Thing. Okay. And so this is an audio version of a meme that you might would see online. Okay.
Right.
Got it. Here we go.
Here we go. When you're 30 minutes in and still five cars behind waiting for your Egg McMuffin in the drive-through line. What are we
Absolutely. And that is usually with your head out the window yelling, what are we waiting for? Why? It's called fast food for a reason.
Oh, boy. Okay, this one is for dog owners. When you're taking your sweet, precious puppy dog out for his last bathroom break of the day, and he's circling the same grassy knoll for the eighth time. What are we waiting
for? Absolutely.
It's like they got to figure out where is that perfect spot to land.
Yeah, I've never understood that because it's a whole giant grassy area, but they're very specific. That's why I'm not a dog owner.
And then finally, and this is something Wally, I think, could attest to, when what took 2 seconds yesterday, your computer seems to be struggling with today, and now you're staring at the pinwheel of death. What are we
waiting for? 1,000,000,000%. I had that happen literally just yesterday. My computer updated, and so now, like, if I want to copy something and put it into a Pages document on my Mac and save it, so I copy it and I tell it to save it as this name, it just spins, and I have to wait for it for about a minute and a half of spinning to stop, and then I have to go type it in myself. So I have no idea what's going on with that.
Does it make you want to ask this one question?
Everything makes me want to ask this. Well, there you go. That is your Audible meme. Thank you, Lady Rock. You're- Interrupting Way FM, this is The Wally Show, and that is the band We The Kingdom and their song Holy Water. Such a great song, and hearing it live is amazing. I got to see them at an event we were at last night, and they were just fantastic.
I bet.
Yeah, because it's like a family band, too, and so they all know each other, and they goof around, and their stories are great and stuff.
Well, and you can tell that they're actually really talented.
Yo, yeah. Mm-hmm. Franny just blows the doors off of it, though. She just has such a cool vibe, and she can sing, and her dad, Ed, is amazing. Like, the whole band is great. So, but it's interesting because recently the news came out that she was going to be leaving for Franny was going to be leaving We The Kingdom. And we had reached out to the record company and said, hey, we'd love to talk about this with them and what's going on. And the record company declined. They're like, oh, they're not talking about it right now. It was really fresh, I guess. But so I run into Franny last night and her dad, Ed, and everything. And I'm like, hey, yeah, we reached out to you guys, you know, your people. We wanted to talk to you about this because I'm just curious. And then when it's said no, then people speculate. And that's why, because I wanted to not have people do that.
Right.
You know, I wanted to hear the actual reason why. And Franny was so kind. She's like, they never asked us. She's like, I would have done it in a heartbeat with you. Mm. You know, I have no problem talking to you and telling the story and stuff like that. And turns out she was like, I spend more time with my dad and my family 5 days a week than I do with my husband.
Oh.
And for her, she was like, that's not balance, and I need to be more intentional and be home with him in this season. And I said, are you going to do some solo stuff? You know, I'm curious. Whoa. Yeah, I planted that seed. Let's go.
A home studio, maybe?
Yeah, and so she's like, yeah, I might do something solo. I'm not 100% sure. But then she didn't close the door on going back to We The Kingdom either. Cool. And what's really cool, here's what's really cool about it. Because We The Kingdom is actually in the studio right now recording their next album with her. Mm-hmm. And they're all super geeked about the music. And they're, like, loving that it's coming out and stuff. And Ed and Scott were like, you should come listen to it because I know you'll tell us the truth. And I'm like, all right, let's go.
You listen to it and you're like, that was bad.
Ooh, I would not do that one.
I don't want to miff you, but
yeah. But that's what Ed likes about me. He's like, I know that when you tell me something, it's always honest. And he's like, we don't get enough of that in this industry. And but it was interesting because she was like, I'm not leaving that door closed. And so she might go back and do something. But what was really cool for them is people are still booking We The Kingdom next year for shows, knowing Franny's not going to be in it. Because it would be real easy for bookers to go, oh, well, it's not going to be the same. Let's not do the show. Mm-hmm. So I love the fact that you could see two, not competing, but emerging different ministries from the same talent pool come out.
Yeah.
It's not like when David Lee Roth left Van Halen and that was atrocious and both bands suffered.
I'm sorry. You're comparing Van Halen and We The Kingdom.
You know
what? Am I getting that right?
Ed Cash from We The Kingdom would definitely appreciate that. That would be a compliment to him. I said, yeah, with her leaving, it's not like when Roth left Van Halen and they wanted him dead. It's like, you can't want that for Franny because she's kind of your kid, right? Am I right? He's like, we'll talk about that later. So everything is good in their camp, and they are fantastic. So if you get a chance to see them before the end of the year on their Christmas tour, definitely worth seeing. And then also still next year, it'll be interesting to see what they choose to do because I know it'll be great. So there you go. That's a little We The Kingdom update.
It's easy to let the fear of the unknown keep us from doing something that is good for us, but going back to school might not be quite what you think.
Yeah, one of my biggest fears going back to school was I'd have to watch a ton of online lectures, and I kind of have a problem staying awake during stuff like that, but it was so different than I had imagined, and way better.
Yeah, for sure. I thought I was going to have to take a bunch of tests, which I am not a fan of, but instead I was able to write papers, which for me was way better.
Plus, you have the flexibility to work in school around your work and life schedule. Another big fear I had is, what if I don't understand something? What do I do?
Yeah, CCU, they foster community with your classmates, and they are a great resource. And Colorado Christian University has very responsive online professors who are there to help you so you are never alone as an online student at CCU.
Learn more about how you can pursue your passion and find your calling with Colorado Christian University at ccu.edu. Colorado Christian University is a nonprofit impact partner committed to cultivating the mind without compromising the heart.
When you say that glass is half full,
instead of just being half full,
or is it half empty?
We'll top off your glass. It's news-ish on The Wally Show.
I saw this headline for something that I was really surprised by, and it had to do with the student loans and how people are starting to repay their student loans. And
this
it was,
isn't a debt forgiveness story?
No, it's not, unfortunately not. But it was. The headline was about this girl who made life changes to pay back her student loans. Because all the headlines before about how horrible it is and how people have been taken advantage of, and this girl had a different take on it. Her name's Nisa, and she graduated in 2020. And she graduated amid COVID, which my daughter graduated college amid COVID. It was such a bummer. Like, they didn't get to walk. They didn't get any of the fanfare. So you have all those years, and then you come out, and you don't get the payoff, and then you have to start paying things off. And so for her, she was excited that the pause happened on student loans. And she says, I definitely felt a sense of relief. Because I was young and it helped me move out and get out on my own. So not having those big payments helped her make some life changes. But then she's like, I knew I was always going to have to pay this back. Mm. That's the difference between her story and a lot of other people. You wait on the government to bail you out. But she's like, I knew I was always going to have to do this. And so being concerned about it, when it kicked back in, I started a side hustle, and every bit of that money is going towards paying off my student loan.
Good for her.
Yeah, it's impressive.
Yeah, her parents have to be proud of her.
Absolutely. You know, yeah, she's like, yeah, it is definitely hard. She works as an account executive for a public relations firm. And so, you know, she cuts back on things. She's doing meal prepping and all the responsible things to, you know, deal with this. And so, Gavin, you're kind of in the same boat as her. Like, your student loans and your wife's just kicked back in.
Yeah, and for us, it's just that style of, like, cutting back on things that we were doing more often. Like, you can find a lot more to do, I think, around your house. Like, we've been doing, game nights where it's just, like, you know, whoever wins the most of a certain game, like just doing stuff like that versus going out and spending money on, like, you know, back-to-back movies.
Gavin started panhandling. He was like, I can do this right around the house. You should be out there with a sign. Help me pay off my student loan. Just be honest. Like, I have a big student loan. Help me pay this off. Because this girl is paying $600 a month in student loans.
Yeah, we're just under that, like, are you? Together. Well, I actually, have you guys seen when you're driving along on the highway and you see, like, people who just got married and they put their Venmo on the back of a car?
Yes.
I'm gonna start doing that.
You should for student loans. Who knows? It might land. So she's got $52,000 in debt, $600 a month. I did the math. It's gonna take her 7.2 years to pay it off at that rate.
It's
under the 10-year thing. But
it's a lot of money every month. But I think if she achieves it in that amount of time, by that eighth year, just the weight off her shoulders.
That's exactly it. I feel bad for people with student loans. I had student loans. Yeah. I had to pay them off. It wasn't fun.
No, it was
not
a choice.
Fun. Exactly. I had to. Now, I personally don't believe that the forgiveness is the way to go of the loans. What I think that should be done is the government needs to say, all right, colleges, we need to rein you in. Mm-hmm. The state school should not be $50,000 a year. You know, that's the whole idea of a state school is that it's affordable, and they've made it where it's not. For the average person, most things in college is not affordable. Yeah. You have to address that issue. You know, and then there also is a personal responsibility. If you're going to go to a college, you can go. At a lot of states, you can go to junior college for free. That's what I did, but I still had to pay for that back then. And then go to your 4-year, which is then 2 years. You're spending way less money.
Yep.
You know, so there are ways to do it. And you don't have to go to the school you want to go to, you know, and get a, you know, teaching degree. Because you can get a teaching degree at other schools, but a lot of times people are like, I want to go to the University of Alabama, you know, because my mom went there or whatever. Great. Well, that's fine. That's a cost that you are going to have to incur for the privilege of doing that when you could have gone to the University of Kennesaw, you know, and still got the same degree, you know. So I think it's a combination of it needs to be regulated, and then it also needs to have some personal responsibility or regulation in there. And then maybe people wouldn't be saddled with such huge debt. Uplifting Way FM, this is The Wally Show, and music is one of the things we do and do best here as we pick songs that matter and land with people, because this should be different than just turning on the radio and listening to some rock station or some pop station or whatever, because those are nice distractions, but they don't feed you, you know? And this is a place that the music is intentional and it feeds you. So from time to time, we like to do this thing called group therapy. This is where we play a little bit of one song and we highlight this one song and we say, okay, what does this song mean to you? What's your story around it? Because I'm always fascinated by the song is the same, but the way it lands with people is completely different.
Because we're all facing different struggles.
Absolutely.
So that's how it works.
Yeah. So what song are you putting up today, Lady Rock?
Yeah, I wanted to put up one that resonates with me, and it's Rachel Lampa's Somebody to You. Don't gotta be somebody when I'm already somebody to you.
Why does this one land with you then? What's your story with it?
I think that as a single 38-year-old, I feel like I have to prove myself that there's nothing wrong with me. It's just that God has a different path for me.
Sure.
Or that just as a woman, I feel like, you know, I have other friends that you get on social media and you feel like your life fails in comparison to theirs, their highlight reel.
Mm-hmm.
And so you feel like you have to live up to other people's standards, but it feels like a weight's lifted off your shoulders when I hear this song, because it reminds me I don't have to prove myself to anyone. Like, to God, that's all that matters. What he thinks is all that matters. It doesn't matter what other people think.
Yeah, and see, this is why I like doing this segment, because this song doesn't land with me like that, but with you it resonates, and I love that. It's great. It's a really strong reason for why this song matters to you, and you've always been somebody to me, so...
Oh, can you sing it?
I don't want to be somebody.
Yeah, okay. Never mind.
Somebody to you. All right, so if you want to weigh in on this, we would love to hear your story. Why does the song by Rachel Lampa, Somebody to You, why does it land with you? What does it mean to you? And you can be part of our group therapy session right now. 855-33-WAY-FM. 855-33-WAY-FM. So why is it that this song landed with you?
So I just listened to Miss Betty Rock, and I want to just kind of piggyback off of that. As a mom who has a lot of kids, and we have adopted kids that have pretty severe behavior issues, and that highlight reel of all these moms that have this beautiful, pretty life, ours is not that. And there's a lot of that judgment that I think I feel from other moms that... I have kids that don't behave in the grocery store. I have kids that don't act quote unquote normal, but it doesn't look like a lot of other families, and it's really messy. And to remember that I'm not accountable to people on Facebook or other women that are raising families. I'm accountable to God for what we're called to do with these kiddos and how we're called to love them.
That is a great perspective on this song and exactly why we do this, because my mind wouldn't have even gone there on this. And so that's why I love hearing your story. I love hearing Betty's story and why we do group therapy. So thank you.
Well, thanks.
And the bill won't be too bad. I think you can use your copay.
Oh, my word.
Excellent.
So, Brittany, why does this song resonate with you?
So, my mom's been an alcoholic since I was a little girl, and she's been in and out of sobriety. And for such a long time, I wanted to try to prove to her that I'm lovable, that I'm more important than the addiction, than the alcohol. And, like, you know, I have children now, and I'm a mom, and, you know, I haven't been able to have that mother figure in my life, and just kind of coming to the realization that really the only one that can love me the way that I need to be loved, that I don't have to prove myself to everybody else, that God is kind of the ultimate parent, the mother, the father, everything to you, and it empowers me to be a better parent to my kids, and it helps me let go of wishing that I could be something or prove something to her.
I love that, Brittany, because I think a lot of us find ourselves trying to earn other people's acceptance or love, and it is a burden that we're not meant to bear. And that's
right.
What's so awesome about having a relationship with God is, like, he's everything we need. And when we realize that and we accept it, the burden lifts off of our shoulders and we can actually live the life that he's meant for us.
Yeah. And God helped me kind of release that, you know, release that stress of feeling like I needed that approval or that love, and just allowed me to kind of love her the way that she could and accept her where she is, just like God accepts us where we are, you know, and kind of let go of that expectation. So.
Random acts of audio.
Up uplifting Way FM. This is the Wally Show. And recently somebody sent me a audio clip because they knew I am a big fan of like Walker Hayes. I like him. He's a country guy. And we had him on the show. We interviewed him about a song about him coming to faith. It's called Craig. It's fantastic. You should check it out. And it's a really good interview. If you ever go to wayfm.com/Wally, you can just search Walker Hayes and it'll come up. But it was an interesting conversation. But you might know him from that TikTok viral sensation song, Fancy Like.
Yeah, we fancy like Applebee's on a date night. Got that Bourbon Street steak with the Oreo shake and some whipped cream on the top.
I mean, this song kind of mapped him. It really helped him break through. And who would have thought? TikTok.
Well, you were a huge fan of it, too, when it first came out.
Yeah,
I hadn't
heard it.
You found it on TikTok, just like all the other 15-year-old girls.
I know, right? And we love it. But it's funny you mentioned 15-year-old girls. He has a new version of this song that he posted on TikTok. And it's him and his daughter doing a dance to this song. But they changed up all the words to it. They did a parody of their own song. And it's Fancy Like Christmas. And that feels really good at this time of year. Here, check a little bit of it out.
So we fancy like Christmas round a fake tree. Nutcracker on a mantle and a candy cane can. I'll get your eggnog with your fruitcake. Go Jesus, whoa. It's your birthday. Bougie like blow-ups in the front yard. Hope a Santa gonna leave an Applebee's gift card in my stocking. Even though we getting naughty all night, that's how we do, how we do. Fancy like Christmas. Fancy like Christmas.
I like that. I just like Walker Hayes. He's funny to me. He kind of name checks a whole bunch of stuff about Christmas in there, but you hear him mention the blow ups in the front yard.
Yeah.
You know how I talked about my neighbors that have the giant Halloween display with four 18-foot skeletons?
Mm-hmm. How do they handle Christmas?
In the past, not well. In the past, there was like one blow up ornament and it was weak sauce.
What is this?
I know. But no, they've changed their ways. They still have a Jack Pumpkin, is it? Because of the Nightmare Before Christmas.
Oh,
so they still they left him. So he's huge. But they went with these two, like they've got to be 20 feet inflatables of Santa and something else and lights. And so like to me, I'm like, you know what? I'm going to slow clap you. I'm not a fan of the Halloween decorations, but the fact that you went like equally as bold for the Christmas.
Well done.
Good on you.
Also, I found out that thing you were talking about earlier with Walker, Walker Hayes, if you want to text the word Walker, W-A-L-K-E-R, to 91979, we'll send you the link. That's Walker to 91979.
So, Betty, you know how I'm very skeptical about Christian movies, at least the ones I'm not in.
of course.
So I got invited to see the movie Journey to Bethlehem, which is a musical about the birth of Christ. So right there, flags go up. I know, right? That's what I thought. But then I started thinking, they turned the story of Alexander Hamilton into a hit musical. So why not the story of Jesus? It should be better, right?
Yeah.
So I go to an advanced screening of the movie Journey to Bethlehem. And I have to tell you, at first I was like, when they started off singing right out of the gate, I'm like, uh-oh, here we go. And I really, as I leaned into it and went with it, I'm like, man, this is actually really good. I really enjoyed it. If you loved High School Musical, Camp Rock, Glee, you and your family will love it because the guy who did a lot of the music for those shows, Adam Anders, directed and did all the music for Journey to Bethlehem.
All in this together.
We'll be singing the songs from Journey to Bethlehem like that too. The movie stars Antonio Banderas as Herod, and I gotta tell you, Joel Smallbone plays his son, and he holds his own with him scene for scene. He was amazing.
I wonder why they didn't ask you to be in it.
I don't know. Maybe because we're all in this together. That's why. Now I see
that's it.
So if you want to check out the movie or learn more about it, it's Journey to Bethlehem movie.com.
TMI, my friends.
Also known as Today's Music Insider with Gavin.
Whether we like it or not, the Christmas season is upon us.
It's right here, man. Shopping has already got me nervous.
Well, you already have a tree up.
I know.
Don't you?
I know. Yeah, we went early this year because we're traveling, so we want to get it done.
Makes
early.
Me feel like I'm cheating on Thanksgiving because it hasn't even happened yet. But with Christmas coming around the corner, a lot of artists in our realm are starting to release their Christmas songs for the year. And I thought we should go through a few of them, judge their, you know, like classic potential, their jingle bell. So I'll start with Matthew West, and I think that this one's probably the most down the, you know, in the middle of what Matthew does.
Peace on earth, good
I like the title because of Bethlehem. Is, I like alliteration, and that's good.
I think it's good. No, it's, I'm all for a reason for the season song, and Matthew, perfect person to do it.
And that one sounds like Matthew there, too. It's not like when somebody does like a Christmas song, they sound totally different. Like, that sounds like him for
Absolutely. The next one is Toby Mac and Tasha Layton.
Oh, I love me some Tasha Layton and Toby.
I think it's a great like combination of the two. This song is called Christmas Hits Different, and I will say
it's a
song, I think, for people who may not look at Christmas as a season where things are perfect.
I like that because a lot of people, that's where they're at.
If Christmas is different this year, you don't have to smile and know how you feel. If Christmas is different this year, I'll be right here. I'll be right here. If Christmas is different this year.
That's kind of cool. I mean, I like the vibe of it. It's definitely, it doesn't feel like a Christmas song per se. But
you can hear just a smidge of jingle bells in the
background. Yeah, you have to have that. That's the only thing that makes them a Christmas song.
Well, and I think for Toby, too, because, you know, he lost his son Truett a few years ago. I'm sure Christmas is a season for
him
personally. It's not quite the same as it was for, you know, the 20 years where he had the whole family together. And then the last song, you just let me know about this one.
We literally just got this one in hot off the presses. We were at an event last night, and We the Kingdom was playing. And they're like, look, we're going to do some Christmas songs and stuff, but we want to do this one. It's brand new. It's Santa Got Caught in a Coconut Tree. And they tried to explain, like, where it came from. And they're finally like, it's just a dumb idea. And we were kidding around, and it was a joke. And then we started thinking about it, because a lot of times you write songs for Christmas in June. And he's like, nothing feels Christmas then. And you got to get in the vibe. And they're like, well, what? Christmas in Hawaii, that would like not feel cold anyway. So let's do this. And it's really funny. Like, I like the fact that it's just nonsensical. Here's a little bit of that. It's We the Kingdom. Christmas in Hawaii is the name of it, if you want to look it up.
Santa got stuck in a coconut tree. Guess he's out of luck, except for me. When I pull him down, the world will sing Merry, Merry Christmas.
Merry, Merry Christmas. They had us all sing with them and like do the thing. Yeah, really, really fun. It was a fun song live. Like, so I believe they're doing a Christmas tour. Like, they're not doing a ton of dates. So if you get a chance to see We the Kingdom on their Christmas thing, they'll do the song, and it's fun live.
Oh, that's really good.
So, yeah, worth checking out. Well, there you go. That's going to do it for your TMI. Thank you, Gavin. Uplifting Way FM, this is The Wally Show. And if you have applied for a job recently or been like on an interview, you might have gotten kind of an unusual or weird question. A lot of hiring managers like to ask those just to kind of see how your brain works and take you out of the normal stuff about compensation and things and see if you can be creative on the spot or pick apart like an answer based on some weird thing that catches you off guard. And one of those is you have five fingers. And so if each finger could expel an infinite amount of liquid, what would you choose? Like, it's kind of like a spout. And so you could make it pour anything. Mm-hmm. And I'm like, I know it sounds dumb, but this question fascinated me because it shows what's important to people. And what they like. And so, Betty Rock, five fingers, what liquids would you shoot? I'm curious how many of us have the same.
One of them would be sweet tea.
Of course.
Okay, yeah, that's your vice.
One would be ketchup, because I feel like I'm in need of ketchup.
Yes!
Ew.
That was mine, too. I have ketchup on mine because, like, how many times do you get something like, I need ketchup, we don't have any here at the station. I'd be like, I got you.
I would do, melted chocolate.
Oh, I didn't think of that. That's a good one. I should have put that on mine. Darn it.
Another one would be ranch.
I don't like ranch, though, so no.
And then I think the last one I would do mace spray.
Mace!
Because, you know, sometimes you got to get people in line.
Yeah, that's so good.
And you could just threaten them. You could just point your finger and they'll be like, I'm sorry.
Yeah.
I'm sorry.
That's pretty good. That's pretty good. I have this and I'm not afraid to use it. Gavin, what about you?
Okay, I went coffee. That's just my thing.
Again, your vice,
I went with water because
is wrong with you? You have an infinite amount of liquid. You can pick anything and you're wasting it. If I'm a hiring manager, I just go, thank you for coming in today. Thank you, sir. Goodbye.
Wow. Dramatic much?
I approached it like I was like on an island, stranded. I need.
Okay.
Okay. Well, okay.
I still wouldn't have.
Mountain Dew, chocolate milk.
Yeah. Oh, just chocolate milk.
Chocolate
for
milk.
The 4 year old in you.
And then the last one I debated kind of with mouthwash.
That's smart.
A moment when you need
that's
to freshen
smart.
Up.
Yeah.
That's honestly smart.
Yeah, like I had to borrow a piece of gum from Betty Rock at an event last night.
But instead, you could just.
I know, I could have just hit it like. Okay.
And you're welcome, everyone.
Yeah. It's okay, so that's not bad. I'm surprised, like I had ketchup like Rock did. I had teriyaki sauce just because I really
I
like
didn't
it.
I think of condiments.
A good teriyaki. I know. Gasoline.
I thought about
yes.
that one. I
but
did think about that one.
But then would that make you, like, combustible?
Oh. Doesn't matter.
I think it's all theoretical.
Doesn't matter. Okay.
Yeah. That's so much money you'd save.
Yeah, but exactly. And then you just, like, anywhere you are, like, oh, I got to fill up my tank. And
yeah.
Like, so it makes so much sense. I would also pick McDonald's Coke, but it has to be McDonald's Coke that expelled through my finger, nothing else, because it's really, really good. And then suntan lotion, but a spray. The spray-on kind. It would be an aerosol.
Why?
Because I hate the lotion. I hate lotion on my hands, but I don't mind the spray.
How often do you put sunscreen on?
I need to do it more. No, I need to do it more. That's why. So that's mine. All right. So what are yours? You've heard all of ours. What are yours? Five fingers, a liquid out of each one, infinite amount. What do you pick? And hopefully you have some that are different from ours. So maybe you had some of the same as ours. Just share with us the one that's different. All right. So 855-33-WAY-FM. That's 855-33-WAY-FM. Just curious. See if you get the job here or not. See like what your answer is.
Job.
Yeah, the hypothetical job. You don't want to work here. No. What would yours be?
Well, if I'm just going to pick one, because I do have several that are similar to y'all's, I would say O negative blood so that I could be a universal donor to anybody.
Oh, that's so sweet.
At first, it sounds really sweet, but let's say you're in a situation where someone is wounded very bad, and they're like, we need you. You would have to then stick your finger into that wound.
Yeah.
You got to do what you got to do, you know?
That's right. Yeah. It's about saving lives. Lindsay is there. Are you type O negative right now?
No, I'm actually O positive, but my mom's O negative, so I've always kind of grown up knowing how special she is with that.
Oh, that's good. It's probably good that you're not, because I mean, you could just cut your finger off and do it.
Don't do that at all.
That's a limited supply.
That's
We're talking
true.
About an unlimited supply where you don't die giving it to somebody.
Jennifer, what would you choose?
Olive oil, because it's expensive and we go through a lot, is the other reason.
Okay, that makes sense.
And vanilla extract, but it's got to be like the primo, like real, you know, organic good.
I love vanilla extract. It makes everything it touches better.
I didn't know that
there's like alcohol in it, though, because I make fudge and I put it in there. And you have to hold it till the end when it's boiled. And then you put the vanilla extract in there and it causes it to reboil for a split second. And I guess it's because there's alcohol in it. Yeah, I had no idea.
I knew there was alcohol in it, but I didn't know that about the boiling. That's interesting.
And, too, just because it smells so good as well. Like, oh, my goodness.
Uh-huh.
When you buy vanilla extract, do they have to card you?
Yeah, exactly. You have to show ID.
I don't think it's that high of an alcohol content.
No, it's not, because I've drank in a bottle before. And,
oh, my God.
No, I'm just kidding. Hey, Jennifer, thanks for being on the show with us today.
All right. Thank you, guys. Have a great one.
And now for some good news.
Yeah! Upliftin' Way FM. This year's the Wally Show with a little good news. Giddy up. A roundup of some good news stories, because the regular news can be a bit of a bummer. I will get things started off. A missing pig named Kevin Bacon.
No, Kevin.
I know. You get it? Was reunited with his owners after help from the real Kevin Bacon. The pig escaped for like 2 weeks, and the owner posted on Facebook about it, asking people to help her find her pig, Kevin Bacon. But what's funny is the real Kevin Bacon saw the story, and he posted about it with a caption, "Bring Kevin Bacon home." Well, pig found his way home. It wasn't like it was a miracle from Kevin Bacon. But the cool thing was, is because of that post going viral for this lady, she was like, I can use this, kind of notoriety to do what I've always wanted to do, and it's open the farm to the public and use it for children and adults who struggle with PTSD, anxiety, depression, and stuff like that. Make it like a therapy farm, which is really cool.
Did she find out the pig was 6 degrees away from
he was actually, yeah. Gavin, what do you got? Good news, good news, go.
A woman in Virginia named Brianna was in line at 7-Eleven when a person in front of her had issues paying, so she paid for their stuff.
I love that.
Random act of kindness on her end. And then she actually bought herself a lottery ticket, and she won $150,000.
Oh, holy cow. You know what? Sometimes you do the right thing, and sometimes it comes back to you like that. That's kind of nice. Lady Rock, what do you got?
There's a small family-owned restaurant in Toronto, Canada, and they are giving out free meals to anyone who needs them. So the owner, what he did was he taped receipts to the front window of the restaurant with a sign that said, if you're hungry and have no money, these meals have been paid for in advance. So you just grab a receipt, hand it to the server, and they bring you a meal. And what's so cool is once people around their town started hearing about this, they wanted to get involved. And the restaurant gave out about 300 meals in the first week alone.
Wow. What's really cool about this is a couple things. One, the restaurant will do well because people are paying it forward and supporting it by buying these meals in advance. The restaurant's already making money on it. Plus, they're feeding people and taking care of people at the same time. That's a win-win all the way across. And plus, the people that do this, they get that feeling inside of themselves of being generous. Mm-hmm. And that does something for them as well. So there you go. That's some great news, actually. And that's why we do Good News Giddy Up.
Growing up in poverty has never been easy for children, but with the added challenges of the pandemic, conflict, and natural disasters, families around the world are facing an unprecedented food crisis. Unfortunately, those who are already hungry are now even more desperate. But by sponsoring a child through Compassion, you can help provide life-sustaining essentials such as food and clean water. And with your compassionate support, that child can not only survive, but also flourish. You can find out how and choose a child to sponsor when you click on the Compassion banner at wayfm.com.
Uplifting Way FM. If it's trending, streaming, or starring, Betty Rock's got it on The Rock Report.
I feel like ever since Taylor Swift and Travis Kelce made it everyone's business to know that they are an item, Travis has been taking advantage of every business opportunity that comes his way, and there are so many.
Yeah.
If you've noticed, he's on lots of commercials these days, one for the Pfizer vaccine, another for State Farm. The list goes on and on.
Let me ask you a question, Gavin, okay, because you know sports. Quarterbacks always get commercials and things like that. Tight ends very rarely. Like Gronk might be an exception to that, but he might be the only one.
Yeah,
you know?
I feel like other than quarterbacks in the league currently, Travis is probably one of the only other ones I ever see.
So I think it would be fair to say that his relationship with Taylor Swift is definitely influencing all these other decisions.
And honestly, I'm sick of it.
But are you tired of Travis Kelce, or are you just tired that Taylor is related to the situation?
No, I just feel like he's using her.
Oh, no. Defending Taylor.
She should see it. Wow. And if they're playing it towards the public to get our money, then I'm even more angry about the situation. Anyways, so while I guess he sees all attention is on him, he's going to ride this train till he can't no more. Him and his brother Jason Kelce, also a football player, have recorded a Christmas song called Fairy Tale of Philadelphia.
Oh, no.
Once again, we
have
too much.
Oh, cool.
That's like a good spin of phrase. Like the brother plays for the Philadelphia Eagles.
Okay.
That's fun.
Okay. There we go. Is it any good?
It's one of many songs featured on the Philadelphia Eagles' second Christmas album.
I remember back in the day when they did the Super Bowl shuffle and all the teams started coming out with albums and they were all horrible.
Well, put this one on the list too.
All right, so Jason and Travis Kelce in their Christmas song.
I could have been someone. Well, so could anyone.
Oh.
You took my dreams from me. When mom first had you, I kept them with me, Jace. I put them with my own. Can't make it all alone. I built my dreams around you.
Okay.
That was bad.
That was bad.
But it's something you can... It made me smile.
No, here's what's going to happen. You see these celebrities where they're like everybody's paying attention to them and they say yes to everything. They're going to look back one day and regret some of these decisions. And I hope that Travis.
They'll regret it while they're standing in line at the bank, like cashing all their checks. Yeah.
Honestly, we're over it.
I love it.
No, that one's a lot.
You're over it.
I'm over it. Yes.
Okay. Well,
it's me. Hi, I'm the problem.
Hey.
Nicely done. Uplifting Way FM. This is the Wally Show, and I think God interacts with each of us a little bit differently. I know there are people that are like, I heard the voice of God telling me this, and they believe it, and that's awesome for them. And I've never heard the audible voice of God myself, but I do believe that I have felt God, for lack of a better term, calling me to do something, you know, and like, you know, you see a need and you're like, I just know I'm supposed to do something.
Yeah, I think most of us feel it in our spirit. It's not so much an audible voice. It's just something that, like, I know, like, I've heard you say this before, Wally, something has occurred to you that something you should do, and you know that you would have never thought of that yourself. Mm-hmm. So you know that it's a God thing. Recently, there's this gospel artist. Her name is Bobby Storm, and she's kind of up and coming. She got the opportunity to be featured with Maverick City Music on their song. And I mean, she can obviously sing. She's doing great. But they were nominated for 2 Grammys. And so she felt like, while she was on a Delta flight, she felt like God was telling her that she needed to stand up midair. So they've already taken off.
Yeah.
And stand in the aisle and sing her song to all the passengers on board.
I can tell you with almost 100% certainty, God has never told anyone to disrupt a plane. Like, well, I'm on it. No, and like, I get that. Like, that's a bold move, you know? And I'm not going to judge whether that was true or not or the motivation of it. Yeah. But, like, let's go under the assumption that that's what she really felt that was God calling her to do. Doing that would be socially terrifying. Like, there's no, I would push that down so many times if I felt God was like, okay, you need to stand up and do a joke for everyone. No, you can't be serious. I would squash that down. But people don't. People are like, all right, Lord, I'll do it. And I respect that.
Yeah, and typically, most of the time when God asks you to do something, it is getting you out of your comfort zone. It is making you do something that you don't feel comfortable with. Now, the situation didn't end well for her, that she got told by the flight attendant that she needed to sit down and be quiet. But, I mean, I know that there's other people that have been felt in their spirit, hey, this is something I think God wants me to do. And it got them out of their comfort zone.
Yeah, and then sometimes you see God show up and do something amazing through it as well. So that's kind of what we want to talk about with you right now. 855-33-WAY-FM. That's 855-33-WAY-FM. Really simple. Have you ever felt God calling you to do something that might have seemed crazy and you followed through with it? And then we're just curious, what happened? You know, 855-33-WAY-FM. We'd love to hear your story right now. Have you ever been in that place where you felt like God was calling you to do something that was super out of your comfort zone, but you did it anyway, Christina?
Oh, goodness, yes. I was sitting in the ER with my mother-in-law, which was raised Pentecostal, and me, I was raised Methodist. but, you know, when I got married, came over to Pentecostal. So I was sitting there with my husband and my mother-in-law, and all of a sudden this lady walked by, and I saw her, and she looked upset. She was with her daughter, and I heard, go pray for her. And I'm like, no, I can't do that. Are you kidding? No. So I said, you know what, God? You move her, and I'll go pray for her. Not soon as I thought that, did she get up out of her chair and walk over to the window by herself.
Oh, boy.
And so then you're like, okay, God, move her a little more to the left. Yep. Okay, now 3 steps to the right, and he keeps doing it. You're like, all right, I'll go.
I know. So I got up, and as soon as she moved, I was like, oh, my goodness. I'm like, honey, I'll be right back. Pat, pray for me. I got up, walked over to her, loved on her. I said, hey, I feel the need. I need to pray for you. I said, do you mind? And I started praying over her. And next thing I know, I felt her daughter hands on me and daughter hands on her. And she said, I just feel so bad. It was a Wednesday night. She was at church, and her husband had been having a heart attack, which I had no clue. Later on, she waited out in the waiting room until we came back out. She was like, yeah, he ended up passing on. Thank you so much for praying for me. I mean, wow.
That's the thing. You never know somebody's story and what they're going through. And when you step out like that, yeah, it does. I mean, you blessed her, but then it also increases your faith, too. And you're like, man, God, thank you for letting me be part of that.
Being bold enough to do it.
Absolutely.
I had never in my life ever prayed over anybody on public like that.
Well, Christina, I appreciate you sharing your story today. And you might give somebody the confidence that they need when they feel God moving in their heart, too, to see how your story played out. And so thank you for being on the show with us.
Awesome. Thank you guys so much.
So what's yours?
Yes, well, I was in a checkout at Walmart, and I was just talking with the lady, and we were having a conversation. She's buying a bunch of calendars, and she was telling me about her sister who was in a nursing home who had just been placed there, but she wasn't sure how long she'd be there for, what her outcome was going to be. As we were just talking, and it was just nudging my heart, like, pray for her, pray for her. And of course, it's like, I'm in this public place, and I've never done this before. And so I went in, and I asked her if I could pray for her. And right there in the checkout aisle, I'm just praying for her. And it was just this amazing feeling, this amazing thing to experience with someone that you just don't know, but that you could share hope with. And it was a blessing for me, and I think it was a blessing for her as well at the same time.
Yeah, it definitely hits both of you. And there are people that are wired like this. They'll just stop and pray with anybody randomly. I'm not wired that way, and so when it happens, it's pretty amazing. You know, I'm sure there were people behind you praying as well, like, I wish these two would hurry up. I got to get checked out of here. But I think for most people, if you ask somebody, hey, I just feel like I should pray for you, do you mind that? Most people won't push back on that, and they're moved by it. And that's God already doing something in their life, and then you just get to be a part of what's going on that he's already doing. What is a situation like that where you stepped out there, Panda?
Well, I tell you, my son, we have an only child, so every time we went on vacation, he would find a friend. And so he found this little boy, they became friends, and therefore we hung out with his parents. And we knew that they were not Christian people. And so on the last day of our trip, we really felt the Lord telling us to give these people a Bible.
Really?
Which was very out of our comfort zone. And we thought, oh my gosh, we're, you know, here we are on vacation and we don't really know these people. And so we went to the nearest Christian bookstore and we found a Bible and we took it. We wrote a little note in it that just said, you know, you'll find all the answers to life's questions in this book. And we gifted it to them. And so these are people, they lived somewhere else. And so I got a message from this lady last year. She found me on Facebook because my name is unusual. And she said that that Bible sat in a box for 8 years, never touched, never looked at. And in the deepest, darkest time of her life, she ran to that basement. And the very first box that she opened was that box that had the Bible in it.
Mm-hmm.
And she said that she has clung to that Bible ever since then. And then she just messaged me a couple weeks ago and said that she got baptized.
Wow.
And so, I mean, it just amazed me that God would know, obviously he does, but way before we did, that how much she would need that. And it just touched us so much.
And it's such a good illustration, though, too, like what you did in that moment. We always want the moment to pay off that minute. Like, I handed them this Bible and then they got saved right then and there. It's amazing. But it sat unused for 8 years. But God knows, you know, and knows what we need when we need it. And she found that book and that Bible when she needed it and when she was ready. And your stepping out in faith was delayed by 8 years, but it paid off in salvation for this lady all those years later. That is absolutely amazing.
Yeah, it was incredible. It literally brought me to tears. I mean, I just couldn't believe that. You know, like you said, you want it to be instant, but, you know, God used that in his time.
Panda, that is a great story. I really appreciate you being on with us today. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you so much. I appreciate it.
I think here's one of the best examples for why we give out free Bibles, too. It's stories like that. You never know how God's going to use his word to impact somebody's life. And so when you support the ministry of YFM, it's one of the things that you're supporting is people getting free Bibles just by texting the word Bible to 91979.
Well, that's the end, but it doesn't have to be. Check out our Aftercast. It's new stuff you didn't hear in the podcast. Be sure to rate us on iTunes as well as connect with us on social media. Just search Wally Show. And if you'd like to join our Facebook group made exclusively for you potties, the link is in the description of this podcast. Thanks to Colorado Christian University Online for supporting what we do.